Hi there and welcome to this video. Today we shall have a second look at the ABC 80, which broke down between my hands last time I tried to make a video about it. I have made a permanent setup for this computer down there in the basement. And today I want to try to fix the keyboard using the first of two methods I found. But before we do that, please like this video and subscribe to my channel. It's gonna be awesome. And while you do that, I'll tell you a little bit about my company, Special Hosting, which sponsors these videos. We make specialized professional hosting solutions based on open source just for you and your purpose. So why don't you give us a call? And now, let's do this. I have gotten some spare parts from Germany, from a company called Jürgen Schäfer MS Tech. I'm not good at German. I bought this one on eBay, so you can probably do that too. These are foam inserts with adhesive on both sides, and I hope that I'll be able to fix the keyboard using those. The keyboard in the ABC80 is a Keytronics keyboard. It is used in a lot of old retro computers as well, so if you search for guides on how to fix the keyboard on, for an instance, a TRS-80, it will basically be the same. I start by taking the printed circuit board off the back of the keyboard, which exposes the pads, and then I gently take out one of the keys. I have to push down the key, and then with a small screwdriver I can tip a little piece of plastic in under the key, which will allow me to take the switch out of the frame. I do this to be able to see what I'm doing when I have to fix the first key here. This is the plastic disc that goes on the bottom of the pad. I try to clean as much of the old foam off it as I can to make the new one stick better. Then I take one of my new pads, remove the adhesive protector and stick it onto the plastic disc. It's a little bit hard to get hang on. And then I push the plastic disc with the new foam on into the key. There's a little plastic thing that will grab onto it, so I just have to click it in place and it will stick there nicely. Then I do the same with the Mylar. I scratch off as much of the old foam as possible to make it clean. And then I stick it on to the other side of the adhesive foam. So this is basically it. Put it back into the keyboard. And then I assemble the computer. And now to see if it works, I fixed the lesser than key. So if I push that and get a lesser than sign, this should work. And that works. And now it's time to rinse and repeat and do the rest of the buttons, or at least those that's not working. Here I push down two buttons. One of them has been fixed and the other one hasn't. The other one still works though, but you can clearly see that the foam has deteriorated even on the working buttons. But I fixed all the non-working buttons, and now I want to celebrate that by writing my obligatory basic program. Enjoy. So, welcome to the editing room. I got the keyboard working again, this is so great. I only switched out those pads who were clearly broken to make the non-working keys work again. As I mentioned in the beginning, I have another method I want to try. I ordered some pads from the States who should be complete with both Mylar on top and the plastic disc on the bottom. So that should be a little bit easier and faster to fix. So I also had a little peek into the cartridge. The cartridge is riveted together. That's kind of weird, so I had to use my boring machine to extract the rivets and have a look at the circuit board. The first thing I noticed was that there was a battery inside and it had leaked. So the cartridge has acid damage all over. So I guess I have a project for another video about the ABC80. Please don't forget to like this video if you liked it, of course. If you didn't, then you know what to do. Also, subscribe to my channel and leave a comment down below and give me your best advice for fixing acid damaged printed circuit boards. See you out there in the dark corners of the interwebs.